I was talking earlier how I considered the sense of community to be the essence of village culture. For it is the community that is the repository of the village's history and identity. And this is particularly evident in the village story and, by extension, the village song. As I mentioned before, there is a close connection between pretty much all the families here. And when you think that these families have lived in this community for several hundreds of years, there is a tremendous continuity that remains unbroken. I heard evidence of this when I was preparing a film about two separate drownings in the river down here. These tragedies occurred almost 100 years apart and were told to be by numerous people. Yet both stories were told as if they were current. But what was really fascinating was that each person told the story in their own style, embellishing here, exaggerating there. Yet the kernel of the story always remained consistent throughout, regardless of who was telling it. I learned from this that as far as the oral tradition is concerned, there is no one single truth, but a multitude of truths.
The river Mrežnica drifts at a pace that is barely perceptible. Its depth in places is up to 15 meters, and the river supports a rich and varied aquatic life.
Here is an example from the Slavic oral tradition, notated some 90-odd years ago. Back then the poems were recited or sung, accompanied by a one-stringed instrument known as a guzla. But in this example of an oral poem, the blue numberings list the point where the three different versions overlap, and the red lines show where each singer embellished the story according to their own invention. It is clear from this that there are certain stock phrases around which each singer would construct their story. So in making my film, I was conscious to include each person's version of the story. When I was studying in London, I first came across this book in the library. But only since I came here has this book become relevant. There are theories here of ancient oral poems and poetry that I've seen in practice in the village. But this book is based on the work of a man called Milman Parry, an American, who between 1933 and 35 travelled through Yugoslavia transcribing examples of oral poems and making recordings of them. He had a theory that the great epics like the Iliad and the Odyssey had been composed in a similar fashion to what he was discovering on his travels. Parry was particularly interested in the structure, the form of the poem, and how that enabled poets to recite very long works from memory. From recording the same song by different performers, he was able to establish that there is a basic central theme onto which the individual poet would embellish the story, according to their will and their skill. But as an additional aid to remembering the lines of verses, they were often written in rhyming couplets and with a regular syllable count of 10. Here is an example from one of the most famous characters of all poetry, Marko Kraljevic. Though I haven't marked every line, you can clearly see that the count of each line comes to 10 syllables. And here are the words of a song by our neighbour Mara in Bukovlje, which follows the same metric and rhyming pattern. This song was probably widely known too, but Mara has personalised it by substituting whatever village name was present before with that of our village, illustrating that elements of the ancient oral tradition are still evident today. When another neighbour Carter recalls her childhood, it is one in which the fields and lanes are filled with singing.
Imali smo ljudi sve po selu, nekad koze, nekad ovce I krave, vole, tako. Ono rozale su na paši curice, pjevale goni doma spaše. To je bilo tako divno za čut. gori zvezde, nebo samo krisio zvijez žabe regeći. Tam i u sumrak oni doma pjevaj, roza i ženske, muški, fakinčići. Pjevalo se i stari ljudi koji su išli na pašuju, oni su pjevali, to je bilo milina za čut.
Over the past 11 or so years, I would always carry a voice recorder around with me, so as to be able to capture any interesting conversations or examples of song. And many of my recordings have inspired me to compose pieces of music based on them. Some of these recordings were simply made when I walked home with a couple of friends from the village.
Dozivalo majku, ubiše ga lovci na proplanku i dozivajući za goricu zađe, plače tužno majku nađe.
Other recordings were made when the occasion was offered, for example, while taking a break from grape picking.
Berem grožđe, biram tamljaniko, i zoro zorice.
On the whole, I've identified two loosely different types of song. Often these are on themes of love and regret. There are those popular ones with the verse and chorus, which are generally known.
Djevojka je ruže brala, pa je zaspala, pa je zaspala.
Or they might have a verse with a repeated refrain, as we can see here in this example, Javore, in which the young girl has personified a maple tree to whom she can confide in.
Oj, livado ros na travo, javore, javore. Oj, livado ros na travo, zlato moje. Koji po tebi čuva stado, javore, javore. Koji po tebi čuva stado, zlato moje.
The other type of song, which more closely resembles the oral tradition, such as in Bukovlje mentioned before, was a song spontaneously composed while people were out with their cattle in the meadow. Now, this was much more difficult to capture, but again it can be observed that they are formed from rhyming couplets and with a regular syllable count.
Najmilije doba. Oj, da mi te je uživa do groba.
In the past, a song was open to everyone and everyone indulged in it. For the older generation these days, shyness now inhibits their singing. From my immediate neighbour Bara, I required weeks of gentle coaxing to get one session, but who later declined to be recorded, even though I recorded a wonderful piece. After that, only one person remained in the village who was willing to be recorded. Our other neighbour, Mara. Despite her infirmities, she embraced the process of filming with great enthusiasm. Even though time had eroded the melody of her voice, she was still able to summon up a tune and record songs, remember songs from her distant past. And I found for myself an additional source of inspiration by composing music to accompany her.
Pod prozorom cvetala mi lala, došo dragi sa mnom razgovara. Curo mala lepa ti je.
Now sadly these days the fields and lanes have fallen silent, but perhaps some of these songs will endure now that she is no longer with us.
Ajde idemo rado, ajde idemo dušo, ajde idemo bijela rado, dole do Morave. Da vidimo rado, da vidimo dušo, da vidimo bijela rado, kako lađa plovi. Lađa plovi rado, lađa plovi dušo, lađa plovi bijela rado, a mornar govori. Ne udaj se rado, ne udaj se dušo, ne udaj se bijela rado, još si dijete mlado. Udaćeš se rado, udaćeš se dušo, udaćeš se bijela rado i dobit ćeš muža. Uvenućeš rado, uvenućeš dušo, uvenućeš bijela rado ko u čaši ruža.